Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Exotic Astrology once again. And we are here today to discuss the retrogression of Venus, which is happening this year for 4 months. All right. So I have drikpanchang.com opened in front of me. And drikpanchang says that Venus will be retrograde on 13th May 2020, Wednesday at 8:44 a.m. Central European time. And it will be progressive, which means it will start moving direct from 25th June 2020, Thursday at 8:47 a.m. Central European time. So the duration of this Venus retrograde is 44 days. So for 44 days, Venus will be retrograde. And of course, he will be in the sign of Taurus during this retrogression. But as you know, retrogression doesn't happen so quickly, which means the planet enters a sign and then slows down and goes stationary there. And then when it goes direct, also the movement is very slow. All right. So therefore, we have to see when it is exactly entering Taurus. Okay. So if you check here, drikpanchang says on 28th March, Saturday 11:25 a.m. Central European time, it enters Taurus. So from 28th March, it is entering, and then it enters Gemini on 1st August 2020, 1:59 a.m. Standard Central European time, Saturday. So that means April, May, June, July. Wow, 4 months. For 4 months, Venus will be in the sign of Taurus, in own sign, Vrishabha Rashi. And within that, for 44 days, Venus will be retrograde from 13th May to 25th June. Okay. So the days 10, 11, 12, 13, May, 14, 15, these 6 days are very crucial. And 23rd, 24th, 25th, 26th, 27th, these 5 days are also very crucial, okay? So the day of retrogression and progression is very important, and 2 days ahead and 2 days behind. And for both, so like that you can say total of around 10 days, which are very important during these 4 months, okay? So Venus will be hovering around in Taurus for the entire summer, I would say, 4 months, the peak 4 months of summer. And currently it is in exaltation in the sign of Pisces, and after some time by end of February it will be going into the sign of Aries, right? And then by end of March it enters the sign of Taurus and it stays there till August 1st. So this is a very long transit of Venus, and as you know, Venus gets retrograde every 18 months. Okay, so the last time Venus was retrograde was in the later half of 2018, when it was retrograde in the sign of Libra. Okay, and Libra is the Mool Trikon sign of Venus, and Taurus is also a very important sign because it is the own sign of Venus. Therefore, this transit is very important related to the houses which Venus rules in your chart. Okay, so those houses are going to undergo the flavor of retrogression for these 4 months, literally. Okay. And then you shall, after August 1st, when it finally enters the sign of Gemini, you could see the results manifesting and you can understand the effects of retrogression. All right. So, therefore, today we shall discuss this transit in short. And if you're new to the channel, please subscribe to it. And if you like this video, share it with others and click the thumbs up at the end. And if you want a consultation from me, you will find my website down in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So what is Venus? Venus represents love, romance, creativity, anything which brings liveliness to your life. That is what Venus is all about. So Venus is a very important planet in Vedic astrology, not only for material progress or for materialistic enjoyment. Venus is very important for spiritual progress also. Yes, many people don't know this. They just think that, Oh, Venus is related to love and romance and sexuality. No, it's not like that. What is basically love and romance and sexuality in today's modern terms? Why does Venus represent that? Because in Kali Yuga, as Kali Yuga is degrading day by day or minute by minute, second by second, those things appear very, very, very lively, you know, associating with the opposite sex, enjoying physically, or showing to others how beautiful you are, showing to others how attractive you are. Those things have got a lot of value because of the degradation of Kali Yuga, and it will only get worse day by day. Okay. So, and then there's the physical pleasure, you know, pleasure of sexuality. So that flickering moments of pleasure seems to be the most appealing thing in Kali Yuga, because the act of sex is actually meant for procreation, and nowadays it is only used for recreation. No? So in Kali Yuga, these things appear very lively because of the degradation. And therefore, these things are represented by Venus. It is not that Venus inherently represents those things. Okay, in Satya Yuga, Venus would represent something else. In Dwapar Yuga, something else. And in Kali Yuga, Treta Yuga, maybe something else. Okay. Now, of course, it irrespective of any yuga, it is always the Karaka for the 7th house and the 4th house, which means it rules marriage and it rules home. These two things are controlled by Venus. He's the Karaka. Karaka means, as I had made a video once, if you have not watched, then please go and watch it. A difference between the house lords and the Karaka. So sometimes many people say Venus is the Karaka for the 7th house, but in my chart, Jupiter rules the 7th. What does this mean? Or Mercury rules the 7th. Okay. So the house lord will always give the results, okay, the physical results, which means if somebody is running the dasha of the 7th lord and the person is of that marriageable age between 25 to 30, then maybe the person can get married, or above 30 also, of course. But of course, if the person is 5 years or 6 years old, then the person will not get married right at that age. But what does this mean when we say Venus is the Karaka for love, for relationships or marriage especially? Venus is not the Karaka for 5th house, you know, love and romance. It is the Karaka for marriage especially. Okay, the 7th house. So therefore, what does this mean? This means the Karaka gives you the ultimate fruit of the event or that house. So when you say somebody's 7th lord is active and the person is above 25, then the physical event of wedding can happen, which means you can find a partner and you might get married, or you might get married to somebody you already know. So, but what does it mean when we say the fruit? So, the event of wedding can take place for anybody, for everybody, maybe for 70 to 80% of the people in this world, they get married. But then, how many percentage, what is the percentage of people who have successful marriages? Okay, when I say successful marriages, I don't mean a marriage without divorce or without separation. Okay, so just because you are not divorced or you are not separated, it does not mean that your marriage is successful. So it could happen that you are staying together, but to what extent do you feel that you are together as a team and you can do better things than you could do when you were alone, right? So that is what Venus, that is exactly what Venus represents. Venus does not represent too much of love or, you know, sexual intimacy. No, that's not Venus. That's more of Rahu stuff. Okay. Yeah, of course, it represents genuine love, of course, at a higher sense, because it gets exalted in Pisces. And when you are truly in love with somebody, which means you want to make somebody happy, that is ruled by the moon actually, not Venus, because Venus rules Libra. Libra is give and take, balance. Okay, you give me this, I give you that. Okay, if you don't give me this, I won't give you that. Okay. So that's what Venus in Libra represents, or that's what Venus or Libra in general represent. But the selfless love, which is there, a man and a woman, or a husband and a wife and a husband, That is more of the Jupiterian love. That is more of the love of the moon. It's like the love of the mother. You know, it's like selfless love. You don't think about yourself. You think about the other person first, right? So that is what Venus. So Venus, what does he represent? He represents the seventh house. So seventh house is basically, it is also the house of marriage. But first of all, it is the house of a union, basically. Okay. Union means not sexual union. It means you were alone, you were single, or maybe you were lonely. And then now you are together with somebody. So if you want to know how Venus is placed in your chart, just see one thing in your life. You don't have to check your horoscope. Okay. And when I say this, people become very angry. They freak out. They say, oh, how dare you say we don't have to check the horoscope? Well, you could do it, but it's like saying you learn the lesson the hard way. The easy way out is to check your own life. Okay. If somebody is new to astrology and you are not interested in deep study of Jyotish, you are only interested in seeing some superficial transit videos, then you can very easily check how Venus is in your chart. Okay, how do you check how Venus is placed in your chart? You have to check that, suppose when you were single or you were alone, and later on if you got married, okay, then did your life become better for yourself? Which means not much of financially or physically, okay, like home perspective, but did you feel that the things that you could do when you were alone, when you were single, now when you are together, you can do those same things in much better way, in a much more efficient way, not on a matter of speed or velocity, that now you needed 2 days, now you can do it in 1 day. Not that much. But overall, has the quality of your life improved after getting married? All right. So that is what is Venus. So if your life has improved, just ask this question. Your gut, there will be a gut feeling. The Paramatma will give you a voice, yes or no. Okay. Are you emotionally more happy, physically more happy, mentally more happy, intellectually you are more happy, overall your society presence has improved. Presence does not mean you have become more famous or you have too many contacts, because you got married to somebody who is very influential. I don't mean that. But in general, are you able to deal with people more, in a better way? So overall, all the areas of your life, or has your health improved, or anything it can be, maybe has your career improved? Okay. So because the seventh house is directly opposite of the Lagna, whatever is there in the seventh house directly aspects the ascendant, and ascendant controls everything. So there you go. Why I say, so if Venus is good in your chart, or in your life, I would say, not in your chart, then you will see that after getting into a relationship or getting married, you become more powerful. Okay. You become more strong. You become better. People come and tell you, you can see in their face, they're happy or they are very content. So, but if Venus is not good in your life, then you will see some people, they were very good, very nice when they were single. But as soon as they got married, their lives have been deteriorating very fast. Some of their lives have been ruined completely. Okay. So that depends on your karma, of course. What is there in your karma, only that happens. And we cannot change that. But the biggest remedy for Venus is to take Venus to Pisces, into the sign of exaltation, which means we do things without expectation. That is the lesson which Venus has to learn. And that is why he is not very happy in Libra. Okay. Libra is not the sign of exaltation. He's happy there, but he doesn't feel that he's at his best. That is why he goes into the house of the enemy, Jupiter, and goes into the sign of Pisces, which shows freedom and selflessness. So now you may be thinking, why am I talking of Libra and Pisces when Venus is transiting Taurus? Okay. Well, because if you want to know how to use the traits of a planet, you must know where it gets exalted, where is the Mool Trikon. Okay. So I also have a video on 3 levels of Venus. You could watch it. You will get more better understanding of that. But Taurus represents all the physical things, okay? Physical things like, you know, beauty or dressing or perfumes, cars, vehicles, home, everything. All those things are represented by Taurus. Yes, cars also. Cars come under Taurus actually, okay? And yes, Cancer also to some extent, because vehicles are represented by the fourth house. And Venus is also the Karaka for vehicles, as I forgot to say. But what do you do with all these things? You know, you have a car, you have a bike, you have a Mercedes, or you have a BMW, or you have a Porsche, or you have a Rolls Royce. What do you do with them? You just sit alone and, you know, you're just driving. No, it doesn't give you fulfillment, you see. So therefore, Taurus represents all those things which you, when you have, it's very good, but it doesn't give you fulfillment unless you share it with somebody. You know? So therefore, you will always see that when you dress very beautifully, when you dress very attractively, you know, or even if you're going to the temple or to the church or to the mosque, you know, not necessarily to some marriage function or to the disco or any other place. It could be even if you go to a temple, you will see if you dress nicely and somebody comes and tells you, oh, my dear sir, you are looking good, or my dear madam, you are looking beautiful. Then you always feel very good, you will see. Even it is always true with any kind of achievement, okay? Imagine you become the president of a country, and then you are sitting all alone and there's nobody to congratulate you. How will you feel? Is it any worth becoming the president of a country? No, it's of no use, because you will feel that, what's this? I mean, nobody has come and told me. You get the first rank in any exam. But imagine nobody comes and congratulates you. How will you feel? Yes, I know somebody will say, no, I will be happy with myself, you know. Maybe, but you will still feel very miserable if nobody comes and tells you. At least for 99% of the people, it is like that. 1% exception, you know. Those who are very elevated spiritually, they know that God is there with me all the time. So he's appreciating me. So I don't need any other person's approval. But for 99% of the public, it is like that they want appreciation, they want recognition, they want affirmation from somebody else. You know, that is what is Libra basically, okay? So, and then when you give it to somebody else, okay, without expecting that you get something in return, that is actually Pisces, okay? So suppose somebody has got some good things in life, or they got married, or they got a child, or they got some a very big job, or they got a new job, or they got a promotion, you know. Then you go and congratulate them. You know, that is like Venus in Pisces, that nothing has happened in your life, but still you are giving that happiness to somebody else, which is very beautiful. So that is what Venus in Pisces does, okay? And Taurus, as you all know, represents those things which we do for our own self, okay? Like we buy a car, or we, you know, dress ourselves, you know, we use makeup and all the stuff. You know, we cook food, the entire food industry is under Taurus, okay? And all the creativity items and anything which appears very charming, which appears very beautiful, is the sign of Taurus, okay? And a planet in the sign of Taurus especially represents the blessings of Lord Shiva, okay? So now what happens when this Venus enters into retrogression in the sign of Taurus? Whichever house Venus rules in your chart, depending on your ascendant, you might feel that you need to work on yourself now for those houses. When Venus was retrograde in Libra, you would have realized, try to go and check back 2018, when those 4 months, you know, the later half of the year, when Venus was retrograde, you know, especially around October, that time Venus was retrograde, and it was in Libra for 4 months. You can try to visualize that time period, okay? You can go to Dik Panchang and check when exactly Venus was in Libra for those 4 months, okay? And retrograde also, of course. So that time you would have realized the houses which Venus rules in your chart, you were not very much concerned about yourself regarding those houses. You were concerned about how do I share them with other people? How do I showcase them in front of others? Okay. How do I get affirmation from others regarding those houses? But now when Venus is retrograde in Taurus, or it will be hopefully, then you will see, you will get a desire that I need to improve myself regarding these houses. It can be anything, you know. It can be like, if it is your 10th lord, then you could feel I need to take certain courses or skills which will improve my career. Okay, if it's marriage, then you will feel I need to improve myself for my married life. Okay, maybe there is some problem in me. So this is a very good time to introspect in ourselves. What am I doing which is not giving me myself fulfillment? Okay, so this is a very good time to work on yourself, to try to see that what can I improve in myself to make my own life better. Okay, so if it is your fourth lord, then the home, you can see what can I do inside the home which can make my home or my life better. Okay, so therefore you know what the houses represent, and but after that you need to check your dashas, which dashas you are running. Okay, and during these 44 days of retrogression, the periods which I mentioned, that during those days, those 44, 45 days, you will see that certain things regarding the areas of improvement related to the houses which Venus rules in your chart, you are redoing it, you are doing it again, because you feel that now there's a better way to do things, and which is very good, it's perfectly fine. Okay, and the house where Taurus is in your chart, which means, because Taurus is again the own sign, so it is like the house is lorded by Venus only. Okay, so that is the area where the flavor will finally manifest. Okay, the final manifestation will be in the house where Taurus is in your chart. Okay, so that is it from my side. This is a very beautiful transit of Venus. So let us see how we can improve the lives of ourselves and others. And by that, we can obtain higher fulfillment in life. All right. Thank you very much. And if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it. And if you like the video, then click the thumbs up and share it with others who are interested to know this transit of Venus. And if you want a consultation from me, you can go down to the description section of my videos to find the link to my website. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to Him and you will find Him.